Welcome to another episode of Who Wants to Be a Farmer? Today we are farming in a Farm Anywhere container farm, and we are going to be harvesting and packing kale. If you've missed the previous videos where we also sowed the seeds, put in a nursery, and then transplanted there, have a look after this video for that. We're also going to be packaging the kale at the end, so stay tuned towards the end of the video to see how we package it. But let's get right into the process of harvesting it. So we're gonna get going with harvesting the kale. Today we're gonna be loose leaf. I was away on vacation, and when that happened, the kale should have been harvested last week. And unfortunately, it's touching a little bit the light. And therefore, we might get some tip burn, we might not. These are good lights with a lens on it, so hopefully it's protected, but we'll see. I'll teach you guys how to address it. First things first, I will put my gloves on for harvesting. And then I also have my harvest knife. And kale is a cut and repeat crop. Therefore, we cut, we could leave it there and come back for more. But we've done the time on this kale already. We've harvested, I think, twice or three times from it already. And therefore, it's time to harvest it completely and to reset the entire table. So I have my harvesting bin here. The next crop coming up in the next video is gonna come here. But for now, since I have space, I will use it as a shelf. If not, I would use my usual cart in the middle here. I've cleaned and sanitized my scissors. And the best part of harvesting kale for the last time is that I get to cut the entire plant off, like so. And then I'm just gonna go straight in my bin and do loose leaf right away. So that way, that's already done. And just put my stems aside and repeat the process. Stem aside. Do a quick inspection here. Okay, so we have one crop right here. There's a little bit of tip burn on this. For me, that's could pass for certain customers. So you have two options. Either you just kind of remove that extra there, like that, just to kind of clean it up so that it looks nice. Or you could just remove it and then keep yourself another bin for things that are good just to bring home. A lot of times with your contracts, you have A grade and B grade. B grade, for example, is to do kale chips in the oven, and therefore it doesn't matter that it's not perfect product. And then A grade is for salads, and therefore it has to look very, very good. And so you could kind of leave yourself in another bin sideways. But I'm actually quite surprised by the performance of the lights, where there's barely any tip burn, and therefore we don't have to address it too much, like my original concern that I mentioned at the beginning of the video. So we're gonna continue harvesting like so. All right, so obviously I would harvest the whole rack, probably a few levels right now to make it worth it, but this is just a demo video. So I'm just gonna start with a tiny little section like this here. I'm gonna bring that into the front lobby and pack it, and then I'm gonna bring another one out, and that will be for cleaning. So we'll show you guys how long it takes to clean these racks and what the procedure looks like. We are, once we've harvested now, we are ready to clean up our sites. And so if you are a two-person team, the best way to do this is to have one person harvest and pick up the old sites, and then someone behind you bring in the new plants from the nursery and replace these sites. And therefore you get 100% efficiency in the container farm. If you want more about how to clean up and what it looks like for cleaning up a whole tray, have a look at our bok choy harvesting video where we go over it in more details. But all of you had questions as to how long it takes and what is involved in that. And so let's get right into the process here. You'll see it's just a few seconds. So I pick my plant site. I rotate a little bit to kind of grab as much roots as I need. I pull the roots out, pull the cube out. That way I can just throw it in the garbage once I'm done, or to compost my basket away, which is going to be clean a little later on, and replace it with a blank site. So we'll repeat the process, try to grab as much roots as possible. Again, remove roots, remove cube, pack the basket for future use, and we replace it like that. If you're doing medialist, then you won't have the rock wool cube, so it'll help. And obviously if you're doing cocoa peat moss or other kind of growing material, you're gonna have like another method to just reuse that cocoa peat moss or whatever other methods you're using. And that's it. That's how we go about cleaning up and harvesting. Let's go into the lobby now and finish our packaging. So we're done with the harvesting. So what I want to do always to try to protect the farm from the environment is close the door behind me. That way if someone comes into the lobby inside the farm, I'm not exposing the main grow room to the outside environment. Next, we have our harvest bins like this. They come in all shapes and sizes, so it doesn't really matter what you use, just to make it easy for you to harvest. And we're gonna always make sure that our environment is in a way that is conducive to being as efficient as possible. So Kale, in the bag, weigh, store aside. All right, so when it comes to weight, especially when it comes to food production, it's important to be as honest as possible in how you weigh your produce, because a lot of the contracts comes with requirements for a certain weight. And that does not include the package. So what we're gonna do is take a Ziploc bag, but you can repeat that for clamshell, whatever the case may be. We're gonna zero out our scale. We're gonna put the bag on it. I'm getting 10 grams. I'm gonna tear it or zero it. And then when I remove my bag, I'm getting minus 10. So now we're not counting the bag in terms of weight. So we're gonna open up our bag here. And what I'm gonna be looking for in this case is to do 250 grams per bag of Kale. That can change based on your agreements. But for now, we're gonna look at that. And then you can pack it in a way that it looks really, really pretty for retail purposes. In this case, this is more of a wholesale package where it will go to a restaurant, let's say. So it doesn't matter as much what it looks like. Let's do a first weigh-in, 150. So we're gonna do another handful here. And I've already kind of gone through all the kale and make sure that all the quality that I wanna give to my customer is already there. So anything that's like yellow or maybe a little bit of tip burn, whatever the case may be, I kind of already pushed them aside. So 220 as I was doing the harvesting. And 240, so probably one more leaf here. There you go, 250, so we're good. So now we're gonna pack that, leave a little bit of air to kind of give it a bit of a cushion. Sometimes you could add amendments in it to make sure that it stays a certain humidity or whatever the case may be, that you can add in there, like little packets of produce that's made for produce. But in this case, we don't have any and we don't need some because it'll be basically delivered today. So let's repeat the process again. And then once that's done, we're only gonna make one lot package with the 250 gram weight and kind of use it a bit as a QA. By reweighing our bags, we can guarantee that we're actually getting the weight that we promise our customer. 220, almost there. And depending on your relationship too, being a little bit over is not a bad thing. So I'm at 270 here, good enough for me. It won't make a big difference at the end of the day. We close that up, put the scale away, time to add the labels. All right, so we've done the packaging labels. Obviously, if you have a POS system or if you're following good agricultural practices and you have a lot number tracking, they could print it for you. In this case, we just wrote it down. So the name of the company that grew it, what it is, what the way it is, lot number, and the date of packaging. So all we gotta do now is glue it on the front page, like so, on the front of the packaging, like so. All right, and that's it for how to grow kale. If you like this video and you'd like to see more, we're working on more harvesting videos and more grow tutorials inside of a shipping container farm. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and all that. Also, subscribe to our channel to see more of these videos. If you have any comments, write them below. We'll do our best to answer your questions if you have any. Click the notification bell also to know when we're coming out with more tutorials on how to be a container farm grower. See you on the next video.